And doors closed. Honda side-by-sides and ATVs are for drivers 16 years and older. Honda recommends that all ATV riders take a training course.
WNAX. It is the Drive Time Show. My name is Vaughn, and that's the legend right over there, Steve Emig.
You know, besides the fact that it was Easter weekend, nearly 700 couples got married in Las Vegas on Saturday. Many said because of the date, April 3rd of 2021. In other words, 4-3-2-1.
I see now. I didn't understand it before. I didn't get it. 4-3-2-1.
Yeah.
And countdown.
Get married.
Lift off.
4-3-2-1. We're married.
Yeah. Well, were you tempted there, Steve Emming?
No, it'd be easy to remember, though, huh?
Yeah, that's true. That's true. 4-3-2-1 would be easy to remember.
Yeah.
I can't remember the date that I got married, Steve Emming. I know,
yeah.
I got married the day after Thanksgiving. That might have been the 23rd. Could have been the 22nd. Might have been the 24th.
Yeah.
But it was November. I know that.
That's key.
Yeah, there we go.
Yeah.
And it was a good idea on my part, Steve Emming. Because if you get married the day after Thanksgiving,
yeah,
the men that have wives, they will slip you a little money under the table because you kept their sweetheart from going Black Friday shopping.
Uh-huh.
Like, man, I tell you what, here's a hundo.
Now
you just
we know.
Saved me a lot of money today because my sweetheart couldn't go Black Friday shopping because of this. Yeah, that's the strategy. 570 WNEX, it is the Drive Time Show.
The D&D Cattle Company Red Angus and Angus Annual Bull Sale is Tuesday, April 6th. Bidding online at BigIron.com. See the bulls in person during their open house Saturday, April 3rd from 11 to 4 at the ranch, Herman, Nebraska. D&D Cattle Company has been selling bulls for over 25 years. Easy keeping, moderate framed, balanced bulls with style, performance, and extreme docility. They build seed stock that works for you. D&D's online bull sale closes Tuesday, April 6th. For a catalog and videos, go to dndcattle.com.
Please join us April 8th at 10:30 a.m. for the Glenn Van Egan Estate Machinery Auction. The sale will be live and online at the farm site by T South Dakota. Featured items that day include a 2020 John Deere 8295R tractor with only 175 hours on it, three restored John Deere 4020s, one that's a power shift and side console, a restored John Deere 4320, a John Deere 7210R, a John Deere 9570 combine with 1,050 separator hours. Also selling that day will be a continuous flow dryer and a 4,500 bushel cone bottom bin, two Brent 644 gravity wagons, a John Deere 2410 30-foot chisel, a John Deere 1760 planter, a 2011 Freightliner with auto shift, MI. GPS equipment includes a 4600 and 2630 screen, John Deere 3000 and 6000 series globe. If you're looking for quality equipment, this sale has it. For more pictures and information, visit westrackins.com or zomerbid.com.
$10,500 now, $500 now, $11,000 now, $11,000 bid, $11,000 now, $11,000 now, $11,000. We've sold the farm for $10,500 per acre.
Get away this summer to Lake of the Woods for top-notch walleye fishing. Steve makes it easy to fish on the Canadian border. And no, you don't need a passport. We've got 9 27-foot boats, all your fishing equipment, lodging, motor coach transportation, and lots of food. It's a 5-day trip in late July with 3 full days of fishing. Find all the details at WNEXtrips.com.
WNAX. Ain't no mountain high enough. Diana Ross helping us out on the Drive Time Show.
Yeah, just when you think they can't break any world records, there's a new Guinness record out. You've seen the gymnasts do forward walkovers.
Oh, I have seen that.
Yeah.
Yes, and it's like, whoa, really?
There's a new record for most forward walkovers in 1 minute.
Yeah, okay. So this person is just like a walking windmill.
Yes. It's a 7-year-old girl.
That's Well, of course. They're the most flexible. Those little kids.
Yes.
They haven't gotten old. They don't have any aches and pains and stuff either.
Yeah.
How many did she do?
64.
Holy moly. So she did 64 forward walkovers in a minute?
1 minute.
That's a...
The old record was 55. So that was held by a 13-year-old. But this 7-year-old from India has the new record.
Really? That's pretty impressive. I bet it was like a wind turbine.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know if I could do one, but...
I can do a cartwheel, and I can do a round-off, which is a cartwheel where you land both feet at the same time.
Yeah.
I do it for money sometimes. I challenge people. It's like, yeah, I can do one. They go, yeah, we'll give you $5 if you can do it.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I usually spend my $5 foolishly, Steve Emming.
Yeah.
After I win the $5.
You ought to bring this little girl along with you sometime.
I should.
And bet people, I'll bet she can do 10.
She would show me up, though. I don't want to be showed up either.
Yeah.
Well, I tell you what, Nelson Cruz did a little showing up today.
Wow. Huh? Well, he finally got to play and start instead of playing in the National League City.
Yeah, well, he had a homer taken away from him.
Yeah,
right?
He actually hit three out of the ballpark, but only two of them counted. Yeah,
two of them were back to back, but only one of those counted.
Yeah, the one that they claim hit the foul pole, but was declared foul.
Now, if it hits the foul pole, it's supposed
to be
ball. Fair, right?
Yeah.
And
they reviewed that one and still thought it didn't hit the foul pole.
You know, when I first saw it, because I was just listening to it, so I didn't see it, but I did. See a replay of it later, and it looked like the ball's trajectory changed.
Yeah.
And it's like, well, and that's what Nelson Cruz thought for sure.
So he said, okay, throw me another ball.
And that was a hit to right field foul pole.
Yeah, but then he hit one out to left.
And then he just cracked one out to left. And what did it come off his bat, like 116.6 miles an hour?
Yeah.
That was cooking there. Wow. Well, the Twins are looking pretty good, Steve Emming. Did you say they're 3-1?
3-1
on the year, and
got two more in Detroit before their home opener coming up on Thursday.
And it's going to be exciting for that home opener. I'm looking forward to it. And of course, you know, if you want to do some traveling with us, you want to do some baseball with us, you just go to wnaxtrips.com. wnaxtrips.com, and you will find information on all the trips that we have going all over the place, including some Twins baseball. We got a couple of Twins baseball weekend getaways, two in the cities and one in St. Louis, Steve Emming. So that should be fun.
A lot of fun.
570 WNAX Coaches Show right around the corner here. 570 WNAX.
When spring comes, it's ready, set, plant. Prepare for your planting window by locking in the right seed and the right seed treatment. With Mustang Seeds, you get the top traits and genetics for your acres with industry-leading on-demand seed treatment for untamed yields. Get ready and get set to plant with Mustang Seeds. Talk to your local DSM or visit MustangSeeds.com today.
Bentco Products T South Dakota announces their new on-site flow monitoring system, which will watch your fertilizer at every row. That's right. The on-site FMS electronically monitors your flow on every row. No more guessing on over and under application. Every row is visually displayed with liquid application amounts from its own flow meter. It's Wi-Fi and Bluetooth compatible to make monitoring simple and efficient. Find out more about the on-site flow monitoring system from Bentco by calling 888-649-4862. Bentco Parts, South Dakota.
The 2021 baseball season is upon us, and we are working hard to help make Target Field safe for your return. This year, we're teaming up with 3M, our official science partner, to implement 3M solutions in cleaning and disinfecting, hygiene, and physical distancing to allow for a safer, cleaner, and healthier environment for you to cheer on your Minnesota Twins. Look for the 3M Clean and Protect certified badge and know we're doing everything possible to make sure everyone can play it safe. Go Twins!
Dibdahl Charlet, Newcastle, Nebraska, will have their 10th annual bull sale Wednesday, April 14th, 1 p.m. at the Laurel Sale Barn, Laurel, Nebraska. Selling 54 Charlet, 2-year-old, 18-month-old, and yearling bulls out of top genetics in the Charlet industry. Also selling one donor flush out of the national champion at both the American Royal and Nile National shows, the great BSCC Miss Gwynn. For a catalog, contact Larry, 402-841-9784, or online, dibdahlcharlet.com.
You've seen the billboards. You've probably been driving by our places for years. From Nebraska all the way through the Dakotas, Western Housing has been providing quality, affordable, modular, and manufactured homes for families like yours for more than 30 years. New or used, or brand new, and designed by you, if you like.
Western Housing, West 12th Street in Sioux Falls. Make an appointment today at western-housing.com, where the best begins.
You want to make sure you're getting the most out of every acre. For over 20 years, Premier Crop Systems has empowered growers to do that through data-driven decisions. In order to maximize your investment from crop inputs, it's important to measure what you want to manage. They analyze all parts of your field to make every dollar matter more. No matter what your equipment is, they help you utilize it effectively and efficiently to improve crop performance. Contact Premier Crop Systems in South Dakota or their other partners in Minnesota, Iowa, and Nebraska. Visit PremierCrop.com and prove it with Premier.
This is WNAX Yankton. Check out the impressive capability of the Ford F-150 at buyfordnow.com. It's 6 o'clock.
Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield IMG College. This is the John Stiegelmeier Show, presented by Covey Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original, and your Jackrabbit headquarters. Also brought to you in part by First Premier Bank, Premier Bank Card. Believe in possibility. Member FDIC. Sanford Health. Even in uncertain times, we're ready to see you. Learn more at sanfordhealth.org. Bud Light. Whenever there's a Jackrabbit game to watch, there's a Bud Light there. Your local Northland Ford dealers. Visit buyfordnow.com. First Bank and Trust. Because everyone should play hard and bank easy. And by Farm Credit Services of America. Call Farm Credit Services of America for your ag financing. Agriculture works here. Now. Here is your host, Tyler Merriam.
Hi, friends, and welcome to the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show, presented by Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill. Alongside the head football coach at SDSU, John Stiegelmeier, I'm Tyler Merriam. It is great to have you with us. We are inside the West Tower of Dana J. Dykhouse Stadium, up on the sixth floor, inside President Dr. Barry Dunn's suite. And for the next hour, we're going to talk about something, I guess. You got any ideas, Coach? It's kind of open mic night here.
Let's talk football, SDSU football. Let's talk Groundhog Day, the movie. let's talk choosing a great attitude, because that's our guys are all practicing right now.
Yep.
And, you know, again, they'll get better today. There's a lot of stuff. I know you got some stuff up your sleeve, too. So
we got a few things, but just at the beginning, for those who may not be aware, the announcement came out earlier this afternoon that because of positive tests in the University of South Dakota's Tier 1 grouping, USD was forced to communicate with the Missouri Valley Football Conference. The Valley has canceled the game for Saturday with USD here in Brookings, meaning it is the third consecutive week SDSU has had a football game nixed from the schedule. As of now, the game next Saturday in Fargo is on, so the Jacks will round out the regular season at North Dakota State on April the 17th, and then hopefully there is an FCS playoff bid on April the 24th. That's what we know as of now. We can discuss all these things as we've got plenty of time here over the next hour to talk about it. But USD having to nix last week's game fairly late in the week certainly was cause for concern because of all the protocols with COVID-19. And now here we are that indeed they had to back out. You feel awful for Coach Nielsen and his student athletes, obviously, just like we talked about last week with Coach Entz and his staff up at North Dakota State and all their student athletes. So what's this like again? Like you said, it's Groundhog Day. We're joking about it. But what's the communication like with the team that we're going through this yet again?
Well, we thank goodness we found out before social media got it, and so I was able to communicate with the players. I'd sent them a practice schedule in the morning, assuming we were going to play the University of South Dakota, and then when it flipped, we changed that around and sent them a new practice schedule. I always remind them we choose our attitude, and it's 90% of how we get by around here, anywhere really. And my fear is when UND started dropping games, I texted Bubba, their head coach, Swigert, and I said, I think I'm going to contact the governor. You know, you really don't deserve to get paid. So now he hasn't texted me yet, but it's going to be 3 weeks without being able to do what we love.
Now, this brings up an interesting question because as someone outside of the football program, my initial concern is this spring season, already there were concerns going in, and we chatted about this a little bit, is that this is a physical sport. It's not like volleyball. It's not like soccer, where soccer you play year-round. In football, you typically have your 3 months, essentially, 3 to 4 months of season, and you do spring football, obviously, and you do workouts in the summer. I'm not saying they're not working out the other 8 months, but that physical nature of things is very much limited to a pretty tight amount of time. Moving this now to the spring, knowing you have a fall schedule as well, there already was, how is this going to work? And you and I had these conversations way back when it started. Now that you've been off, this will be the third consecutive week, is there concerns from a physical standpoint of having this long layoff and then starting up again?
No. In fact, I think it's the opposite, Tyler. Okay. I think we're getting guys back. Guys are getting healthier. We've talked about this. After the first game of any season, there are guys that go in the training room every day because of the bumps and bruises, and you got to practice football, so they always are maintained. Well, now with 3 weeks off, we talked a little bit about it, we're going to be a little rusty. Yeah. We'll be healthier, but we'll be a little rusty in terms of tackling and blocking, and that's why today we're going good on good. We're going ones versus ones, not live tackle, but ones versus ones, so we get the best reps we get during a football season when you go against your best guys.
The team, the buy-in here has not changed. Because, again, I'm asking this because it's simple for people outside to say, well, you know, they'll cancel it. Now there's no point for them to go on. The attitude of this football team is the same it was 6-8 weeks ago.
Well, yeah, we're ranked the third seed right now in the the mid-season picks. So, I mean, there's a picture out there that there's something special to play for. Now, a lot of things have to happen, and we have to have the playoffs and those types of things, but they're excited about that. You know, I would say I'll go back to the start of fall camp back in January when Chris, our mental strength coach, said – talked about Syracuse. Syracuse had won. I don't think they won a game in the fall. They had one positive test the whole season. He said it can happen. We haven't had one yet. And so we talk about commitment and excitement and wanting to play the game of football. Hopefully have another week like that, and we're in good shape to move on.
Well, we've got a full hour here to cover a lot of different subjects here on the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show. We want to remind you, our friends at Cubby Sports Bar and Grill are the presenting sponsor of the show. They got a big special this week. Are you ready for this, Coach? It is the chorizo burger. All right. It is ground beef and chorizo mixed together. It is grilled and topped with chimichurri, pepper jack cheese, tomato, and avocado, and it is all served not just on a regular bagel, but a jalapeno bagel. Your mouth is not watering.
I love my double cheeseburger. I'm sure that's delicious. It really is, but I love the double cheeseburger.
I'll tell you what, I don't think I can do the chimichurri. I don't think I can do that. But everything else I could. I would be willing to try it once.
Well, you can have it without the chimichurri.
Well, that's what I'm saying. I'm going to have to get it without the chimichurri.
So I think that should be a part of our show. I think you should go down and sample what you preach, what you push, and then talk about how it was the next week. How good it was the next week.
Why are you excluding yourself from this conversation? Shouldn't we both try it and then both discuss how it went?
We could do that.
I mean, the Food Network makes stars out of regular people on these subjects. Certainly you and I have something in store. I mean,
you know, we could go that way too. I make the coaches a meal every Wednesday. So, I mean, we could also talk about the meal I make, but that'd be really boring.
What are you making on Wednesday?
Chicken wild rice soup.
Okay. All by yourself? Are you getting any help here from Lori or anybody else?
Lori gives me the recipe.
Okay.
It's really pretty easy, but it's they love it, so.
They tell you they love it. What are they going to say?
No.
The head coach says, what do you think of the meal I just cooked?
No. They don't say that. I look at what's left, and I know they liked it, loved it.
Okay. They're football guys. They'll eat anything that's free.
Probably.
And I speak knowing because I'm a member of the media. I'm the same way. Free food, we attack that buffet. We've got a lot to get to here on the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show, I think. We've got some questions for the coach. Hey, here's one for you. I want to test your Jackrabbit football knowledge here.
I'm afraid you're going to do this.
This is an educational opportunity for everybody. But and I'll be honest, like this one here, I didn't know this. I looked it up, and I was curious, okay? There have been some phenomenal receivers in the history of Jackrabbit football, whether it's tight ends, wide receivers, guys out of the backfield, guys who have led the team in receptions a single season, guys who have led the team in receptions twice. There's only been two players in the history of Jackrabbit football to lead the team in receptions three different seasons. And I didn't know how many there were. I was curious. I looked it up just a little while before we came on the air. There were two of them. Would you like to take a guess to either one of them?
I would guess, and it's total guess, Jake Winicky.
Nope.
Not Cade, right?
Not Cade, nope.
Are they in my era?
No. Well, one of them was it. One of them would have been back during your time as a student coach. Winicky did it twice, but then Goddard did it twice. That's the thing. You go back through, Jeff Tiefenthaler had an unbelievable career, but Dennis Thomas led the team in receptions in 84, not Tiefenthaler.
Right.
He only did it in 85 and 86. Mike Ethier,
okay.
1981, 82, and 83.
Cool.
And the other one, you got to go into the Wayback Machine. Roger Eichens did it in the early 60s.
How many did he have?
In 1960, he had 13.
That led the team.
Then he established a school record the following year with 27.
Times have changed.
Times have changed indeed. As a matter of fact, that's one for you. Monty Moseman in 1976 caught 51 passes. That was the school record for 10 years. Tiefenthaler then broke it with 54 and then 73. And that 73 stood until Jason Schneider. So
Monty was a tight end. So that's
Monty
amazing
was a tight end.
In that era to catch that many passes.
That was a different style of offense the Jacks ran back in those days.
I'm guessing there were two backs in the backfield.
At least. Much more to come on the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show. Stay tuned. You're listening to the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield, IMG College.
Walk these fields for 8 decades. Grow deeper roots here. Know what thrives here. Bring in world-class genetics and innovative traits like Chrome Triple Stack Corn Hybrids and Enlist E3 soybeans. Refine it through pure local know-how and expertise. Do all of that, and the only thing left is the right seed. Hogemeyer Hybrids. Learn more at therightseed.com.
In South Dakota, farming is more than cornfields and combines. It's the small moments and big challenges we all face every day. It's getting up in the morning, taking care of what needs to be done, doing the best you can, and being thankful for the opportunity to do it again tomorrow. This is real. This is life. This is farming. To learn more about farming, visit thisisfarming.org. Brought to you by South Dakota Corn.
Okay, Jacks fans, let's make some noise.
Go Jack!
Okay, Jacks fans, when he's at SDSU, First Dakota Chairman of the Board and CEO Larry Ness is usually getting pumped up about investing in new ideas by educating tomorrow's financial leaders through the First Dakota E-Trade Lab. But when the Jacks hit the field, the only banking activity Larry does is bank some noise.
Go Jacks!
Bank some noise with us at firstdakota.com, member FDIC.
Cubby Sports Bar and Grill is your sports headquarters, with more than 50 TVs providing the area's best sports viewing environment, including the NFL Sunday Ticket, ESPN College Extra, NHL Center Ice, and other sports packages, plus daily food and drink specials, open to all ages daily at 11 and Saturdays at 10. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original in downtown Brookings, and a proud sponsor of the Jacks.
Becoming America's best-selling brand means you never settle. Like the Ford F-150, completely rebuilt from the ground up to be smarter and tougher than ever. Or the Ford Bronco Sport, with a legacy that can't be broken. The entire Bronco family is designed, engineered, and built for adventure. Plus, Ford's complete lineup of SUVs gives you the power, style, and space you need for life on the go. Go to buyfordnow.com or contact your local Northland Ford dealer for exclusive offers on the perfect Ford for you. Sales claim based on calendar year sales.
At Wiffles Hybrids, our family recipe for success has been handed down for three generations. Take two parts high-performing hybrids, mix with one part unmatched quality, then finish it off with our secret sauce, superior customer service. Some people may say it's impossible to get the best hybrids from an independent, family-owned company, to which we'd say, have your cake and eat it too. Mmm, Wiffles Hybrids, quite possibly the best hybrids you can buy.
The John Stiegelmeier Radio Show, no doubt award-winning when we get done with this one-hour episode, is presented by Cubby Sports Bar and Grill. He is the head coach of the Yellow and Blue. His Twitter handle is Holy Nutmeg. I'm Tyler Merriam. My Twitter handle is just Tyler Merriam. And we say you're the most boring football coach in the country. You have suggested that before. And yet that Twitter handle just captures everybody's attention when they are Holy Nutmeg.
Well, yeah, but I didn't know anything about Twitter when I created it. And in fact, I didn't create it. I think it was Blake Day or somebody came over and said, we got to create Twitter. So, I get a lot of criticism because if I just used my name, it would be a lot easier to figure out, I guess. But again, I didn't set it up, so I had no choice. Holy Nutmeg is when I get excited on the football field. I can't believe what I'm seeing. I can't believe what I saw on a play or something. And so when I get excited, instead of what many coaches use opportunity is say profanity, I use Holy Nutmeg. And so hopefully that opens some eyes and gets guys a little sharper.
Did you hear somebody say that once?
No.
You
no,
just
I have no idea why it came up.
Really?
Yeah.
Because obviously there's Holy Cow, that's gone. I mean, many famous broadcasters have used that term. And Holy Toledo is another one. Bill King, the longtime voice of the Oakland and Los Angeles Raiders, used to say Holy Toledo all the time. But nobody says Holy Nutmeg. Maybe
probably a reason.
Maybe Holy Chimichurri is next up on the list. You know, by the way, thanks to our sponsors, Cubby Sports Bar and Grill. Last week it came out, and we did not touch on it, but we should here. Before we do that, just a reminder, there is no football game this Saturday. The announcement coming earlier on today, the University of South Dakota, due to positive tests in its Tier 1 group, unable to play this. Hey, while we're talking about that, let's throw this out. Because I've had people ask me this recently, including my father. I see this Tier 1 stuff. What does Tier 1 mean? And I think we've gotten so accustomed to it, you and I, because we're in the thick of it, we just assume everybody knows Tier 1, Tier 2, Tier 3, and what we're talking about. Give us, from your standpoint, what these terms mean.
Well, it's the vicinity to our program. You know, the bubble, the inner bubble would be our players, our support staff, our filmers are part of that, GAs, coaches are part of that. And then as you reach out, like, I don't know what tier the chain gang is in, but they're not in Tier 1 because they're not around our football team. So all I care about is we get all negatives when we test on Wednesdays and we're able to do what we love to do.
Yeah, Tier 1 will be those with direct personal contact with the student athletes where it could be close contact. Then you have Tier 2 where they may be around them briefly. And then Tier 3. So, for instance, at a home football game, those of us who are up in the press box all game, we're Tier 3 because we have no contact on game day. Where those who are direct, for instance, our video guy Chris, who is in the locker room with you guys, handles your press conferences, he's Tier 1 because he's right there with you guys. So he has to test on the same layer that you guys do that week to make sure that everything is as safe as possible.
Yeah, and it again, all this stuff has evolved. I remember when in August, and I'm serious about this, when this stuff came out, we were going to always Zoom meet, and then we're going to practice in two different groups. So you didn't have your entire O-line, and it's just things have kind of calmed down in terms of how you can really get COVID when you're practicing football, which has allowed us to meet now socially distanced and then practice normally. But I mean, and that's all, you know, kind of evolved as we've gone through the tiers and that type of deal.
Yeah, obviously everything following CDC guidelines. We've talked about it before. Charlie Miller, who received an award this week as the Athletic Trainer of the Week nationally for his work, and Kelsey and the crew down the line, certainly Ben Hines at the top of the list, their work following the CDC guidelines. Because, again, the more we find out about COVID-19, those guidelines and protocols change, and how SDSU handles it changes with it. And so we have learned to be really flexible the last 6 months.
Well, yeah. I mean, it's defined flexibility, yeah. You know. Now just take the last 3 weeks and what yeah. our guys have been through. And we asked them to stay here for Easter. We practiced Saturday morning just to get a good practice in. And asked them, we got them a meal for Easter, but hope they didn't go home and, mm-hmm. and be around people that, yeah, they love them, but who knows? They're not in our bubble. So it's been unique. I keep telling them they're part of history. You know, yeah. this is going to be in a history book, and they're going to be able to talk about what they're part of it. So
no, you're exactly right. This is what I was starting to allude to before we got sidetracked a little bit. We found this out last Monday, and I'll read from the press release. Adam Vinatieri, who excelled at South Dakota State before becoming the National Football League's all-time leading scorer, one of four people selected last week to be enshrined in the COSIDA Academic All-America Hall of Fame class of 2021. Created back in 1988, the Academic All-America Hall of Fame recognizes former Academic All-Americans who received a college degree at least 10 years before they receive this award. They have achieved lifetime success in their professional careers and are committed to philanthropic causes. And the Hall of Fame inductees join the prestigious group of 158 members in a ceremony on June the 9th. Of course, Vinatieri, four Super Bowl rings, two game-winning kicks in the Super Bowl. He's the NFL's all-time leader, 2,673 points. And I know that you have a ton of stories about Vinny. My factoid I love to throw out to people is the fact that he's going into the Pro Football Hall of Fame. I mean, it's just a matter of time. He will go into the Pro Football Hall of Fame as a kicker, and yet he was all-conference not as a kicker but as a punter at South Dakota State University, and at one point was replaced for an offensive lineman of his place-kicking duties, was he not?
D-lineman.
D-lineman, excuse me, yes.
Yeah. Well, first of all, back to Adam, what a neat honor. What an unbelievable honor, you know, because it's you are an academic All-American, but then you didn't sit around. You have all those other things you're doing to be able to get into this elite group. You know, Adam, very talented guy, very athletic guy. You know, to do him justice, he did the punting and the kicking, which is not an easy thing to do. Mm-hmm. And struggled a little bit towards the end, probably more because of the coaching staff expectations and pressure and so on. And Jim Remy did do some kicking towards the end. But what an unbelievable story that he packed his bags and literally defined the term "pursue my dream," and his dream came true. And the story that I don't think anybody ever talks about, when he went to New England, I think he was just there to rest Matt Barr's leg. He was there as a backup kicker to get through the preseason, and he beat him out. And the rest literally is history. And we're really proud of him. We're really proud of him.
Yeah, Bill Parcells, when he got the job in New England, brought the kicker he'd had with the Giants in. Everybody assumed it was Barr's job, and he decided to take a chance on Vinatieri. And Vinny, I think, has joked how nervous he was those first couple of kicks because he didn't know how long he'd have this job. Well, it turned out all right for him.
Yeah, yeah, he's had a great career. He's been very generous in a lot of areas. And I'll never forget the time he drove down from Indianapolis to our game at Indiana State and addressed the team in the locker room. And that was special for our players.
We talk about Vinatieri and everything he accomplished. There are two very unique marks established by SDSU wide receivers in program history. One of them is consecutive games with a touchdown reception. 14 of them by whom?
I'm guessing Winicky again.
No, Tiefenthaler. Jeff Tiefenthaler, Division II record, 14 consecutive games with a touchdown reception. That was, at the time, a D2 record from October of 84 through 85. And so he did all that with Mike Bush. Then in 86, had another stellar season with Ted Wall. I know you were not here for Jeff Tiefenthaler, for the student-athlete that he was, but you go back and watch video, you've seen clips, and certainly you got to coach his son. What a special student athlete Jeff Tiefenthaler was.
Yeah, he really was a college track ability. So his speed was really good at that point in the history of SDSU football. And I know I think, I don't know if this is a stat, but I'm guessing he has a pretty good yards per catch average in his record.
He certainly does. And you mentioned the whole track thing. He was brought in as a sprinter and was not originally a football player, but he claims he was getting some guff about how he couldn't cut it in football, and so he said, okay, I'll show you guys how this works. And Jeff's never one to shy away from telling a story, so he has shared that a time or two. Now, you mentioned Jake Winicky. You are correct in the second one. He caught at least one touchdown pass in 35 different games. Not just a pass, a touchdown pass. Yeah. In 35 different games, had 59 career scoring catches. And there were games, I can think back to the first game in stadium history when we opened up Dana J. Dykhouse Stadium. Drake held him to three catches. They were all three for touchdowns. I mean, Jake Winicky was something else.
Not only was he a great football player, is he a great football player? He is an unbelievable person.
Yes.
And he's a guy that always had a smile on his face, never had a tough day, never had a bad day. He would do anything for anybody, not just his teammates. I swear, I see people walking around with football gear or backpacks, and Jake would share it with him because he had one, didn't need any more. I love that about him. He's been on mission trips. He's a dad now. I was able to go to New York with him for
That's
the
right.
Campbell Trophy. What a fun experience to be there with his mom and dad, and just really, really blessed to be around guys like him.
Now, one of the best receivers in the history of the Football Championship Subdivision, Maple Grove, Minnesota's own Jake Winicky. More to come here on the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show, presented by Cubby Sports Bar and Grill. We've got a few other teasers here for the coach. He's going to talk some special situations, and we'll update you on where things sit nationally. Coach teased it a little while ago. The Jackrabbits, both in the FCS national polls and also on the playoff committee's initial rankings. We'll talk about that when you return. This is the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield, IMG College.
Cubby Sports Bar and Grill is your sports headquarters, with more than 50 TVs providing the area's best sports viewing environment, including the NFL Sunday Ticket, ESPN College Extra, NHL Center Ice, and other sports packages, plus daily food and drink specials, open to all ages daily at 11 and Saturdays at 10. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original in downtown Brookings, and a proud sponsor of the Jacks.
Here's a pop quiz for corn growers. Of the top three seed corn brands in the Central Corn Belt, only one is 100% focused on seed corn. U.S. farm family owned and got there without the help of a parent company. Any guesses? That's right. Wiffles Hybrids. Officially making them the grown-up in the field. Wiffles Hybrids. One thing done right.
It's back, the return of the prestigious Learfield IMG College Directors' Cup, honoring college sports excellence across all competitive divisions, both men's and women's sports. Follow along with L Directors' Cup on Twitter or online to see which schools will be taking home a first-place trophy in June for their season-long success. Learfield IMG College Directors' Cup, a premier institutional award jointly launched in 1993 by USA Today and NACTA.
The past year, we've taken some things for granted, such as the importance of a consistent food supply chain, gathering in large groups, and the fall football season. Just as SDSU football is innovating to offer spring football games, so too is the ag industry constantly innovating to provide a safe and reliable supply of affordable and healthy food for your family's table. South Dakota Farm Bureau's game plan is to find wins for agriculture by supporting the industry through policy development and advocacy. South Dakota Farm Bureau, a proud supporter of SDSU athletics. Go Jacks!
In South Dakota, farming is more than cornfields and combines. It's the small moments and big challenges we all face every day. It's getting up in the morning, taking care of what needs to be done, doing the best you can, and being thankful for the opportunity to do it again tomorrow. This is real. This is life. This is farming. To learn more about farming, visit thisisfarming.org. Brought to you by South Dakota Corn.
Becoming America's best-selling brand means you never settle. Like the Ford F-150, completely rebuilt from the ground up to be smarter and tougher than ever. Or the Ford Bronco Sport, with a legacy that can't be broken. The entire Bronco family is designed, engineered, and built for adventure. Plus, Ford's complete lineup of SUVs gives you the power, style, and space you need for life on the go. Go to buyfordnow.com or contact your local Northland Ford dealer for exclusive offers on the perfect Ford for you. Sales claim based on calendar year sales.
Let's be real. You want views. You love windows. You need space. You hate commuting. We understand the wishes you have for your new home. That's why First Bank and Trust is here with local mortgage lenders to make your loan process easier. We work hard to keep things on track so you close on time. Plus, we're big enough to offer competitive rates. We're also small enough to know your neighborhood. Hey, we might even know your neighbors. First Bank and Trust. Real banking. Real easy. Member FDIC. Equal housing lender.
Midco Sports Network is proud to bring fans live regional sports coverage. No matter what this season brings, our goal to provide the best local sports coverage remains.
Oh! Jax, Winicky's got himself open over the middle.
From the field to your screen, Midco Sports Network brings you the best in regional sports coverage.
Touchdown, Jackrabbits!
Midco SN, celebrating 10 years of sports.
The John Stiegelmeier Radio Show is live, presented by Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill with the originator of Holy Nutmeg. I'm Tyler Merriam. It is great to have you alongside. There is no football for the third consecutive Saturday for the yellow and blue. The SDSU football team's Saturday tilt expected to be here in Brookings against the University of South Dakota, wiped off the slate due to COVID-19 protocols. So for the third straight week, there is no football game. The Jacks are still scheduled to play at North Dakota State a week from Saturday in the regular season finale and then on to the FCS playoffs from there. And Coach, a couple of notes with that. NDSU earlier today, Matt Entz held a press conference, said there have been no positive tests in the Bison program the last couple of times around as far as they are concerned. They are very optimistic they'll be able to play football here and finish out the regular season. So certainly we hope that is good news. We've learned here because we've talked about shows before. We sat here on Monday night. Oh, yep, we feel good. We're going to have football. Within 24 hours, we don't. So anything's possible on all sides. But feel good where things are at right now, where things are trending, that we can find a way to get one more game in and then get to the postseason.
Well, I feel good that we're going to do what we're supposed to do. And we we've talked about this so many times. We depend on each other. You know, our players depend on each other, Everybody doing their part, and simply making the correct decision, which is our only rule. And then obviously North Dakota State's people depend on each other up there, and then we can play the game. And we would really look forward to that. But again, we're going to choose a positive attitude, whatever happens around here.
Now, as you've brought up a couple of times on this show, it is a different FCS playoff format than in the past. Traditionally, it has been 24 teams, the top eight earned byes, and that's how the playoff system has been formulated the last few years. This year, it's contracted to 16 because of the COVID-19 scenario. So 16 teams will make it, so limited number of at-larges, and eight sites they will attempt to predetermine in the first round. Now, what we mean by that is they will try to pick those eight sites in advance, but if you're picked to host as one of the top eight seeds and you have already been chosen to host as well, you'll get to host that game. So it's not as if SDSU puts a bid in to host and is, let's say, the number two seed. It wouldn't be at home, but it may be a case of if some team is in the top eight but didn't bid, then it would have to play a neutral site game, essentially. That's your understanding, correct?
Well, yeah, and they're certifying, I think, up to 16 sites. You know, and my vision or my thought would be they want these scattered across the United States. So let's just take a crazy thing. Let's say none of us in the Missouri Valley choose to host. Well, they would want to have something close to us to accommodate, ideally, three of our teams making the playoffs.
Well, the FCS playoff committee, somewhat in the secrets of darkness, came out with a top 10 ranking last week. They didn't really tell anybody in advance they were going to do this. If you were watching a college baseball game on ESPNU, as I happened to be last week, all of a sudden, hey, there's the FCS playoff committee's top 10. So they released where things are at now. And going into last weekend, James Madison was the number one seed. North Dakota State 2, South Dakota State 3. What'd you say? That's kind of a big game in Fargo next week?
Yeah, it's a huge game.
Yeah, it's kind of got some meaning to it. Sam Houston is 4. North Dakota is 5. Weber State 6. Delaware 7. The Cadets of VMI are 8. UC Davis 9. And the Racers of Murray State are 10. So that's the FCS Playoff Committee's top 10 at the moment. And again, we envision, if possible, the top 8 seeds would host the bottom 8 seeds. But we don't know exactly, and some of that stuff hasn't been officially locked in stone yet by the NCAA and the FCS playoff committee. But as you pointed out, 3 of the top 5 teams come out of the Missouri Valley Football Conference.
Right, right. And the 9 and 10 teams lost last week. So
yes.
I think they're going to struggle to – I know Davis will struggle because they're 3-2 right now. You know, we just want to win out. We want to have a chance to win, and I think it would set us up for – wherever the sites are, a pretty good situation for our football team. And that's been our vision. That's been our goal. And we want to have a shot at it.
Well, it'll be interesting to see how all this plays out. That is the only time we believe during the spring season the FCS playoff committee will make that announcement. So the thought process here is that a week from Saturday, the Jacks will play up in Fargo. Then the next day, the selection committee will make public the 16 teams that are in the playoffs, and then the 8 matchups, the sites, and obviously we'll go through all of that and figure out the protocols and whatnot, because this certainly is the most unique of scenarios. When I say Columbus College to you, does that mean anything?
It does not.
It does not mean anything to you. How about the VA hospital in Sioux Falls? Does that mean anything to you?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Columbus College was located in Sioux Falls on the grounds of what is now the VA hospital. Columbus College was a private Catholic institution that went by the wayside when the Great Depression occurred, so it closed its doors in 1929. It was in Chamberlain for a while, then went to Sioux Falls. Why are we talking about this? Because it is a footnote in history of the greatest individual performance that South Dakota State football has ever seen. 1922, Stig, Ross Owen. Ross Owen scored 8 touchdowns in that 1922 game. Okay.
Against
Columbus College.
Right.
We do not know exactly how many yards he had, because he had the single game rushing record up until the 60s based on just the yardage total of his 8 touchdowns. But everybody readily admits in the various newspaper clippings, the handful that can be found from this 1922 affair, that everybody kind of just stopped keeping track late in the third quarter of this 4-quarter game. So Ross Owen has the school record with 8 rushing touchdowns in a game, 48 points scored in that 1922 affair against Columbus College, who, again, apparently was a dominant program in football in the later portion of the 1920s in the SDIC before, of course, eventually it would no longer exist, and now the VA hospital sits there. But Ross Owen against Columbus College in 1922. And just to fill out the whole story of this thing, I want to make sure I get this right, Stig, so I'm going to look it up one more time. The final score of that game, which previously was the school record for scoring until a game you were involved in, 85-0. And we're not 100% sure that was the final, because, again, everybody kind of threw their hands up in the fourth quarter. We didn't have a web stream, and we didn't have state-of-the-art scoreboards to keep track of all this stuff.
Well, we have a postulate about the game I was involved in. And, again, if I'm blessed to be a head coach for a number of years, that will never happen again at South Dakota State football.
I think we've seen a couple of examples of that, of 9-minute drives in the fourth quarter of games that would ensure that would never happen again.
Well, there's a lot of positives about a 9-minute drive.
There certainly are. We've got more to get to here on the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show, presented by Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill. We're going to test Coach Stig's knowledge. He has some special situations he would like to discuss with us. All that and more coming up in just a moment, so stay tuned. This is the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield, IMG College.
let's be real. When it's time to start adulting, teens need a bank account, like a Real Deal bank account, one that's free and offers some perks. Check out Real Deal Checking from First Bank and Trust. It's free checking with ATM fee refunds, a free custom image debit card, and cash rewards when you qualify. You get free mobile banking with all its cool capabilities, and seriously, your personal finance teacher would be so impressed. Real Deal Checking by First Bank and Trust. Real banking, real easy. For full details, visit bankeasy.com or stop in today.
Member FDIC.
Spend more moments in the moment, not in pain, with orthopedics and sports medicine care from Sanford Health. Our team is here to help you overcome joint issues, athletic injuries, and anything else holding you back. Experience care available when you need it, treatment options that go beyond the expected, and a plan that is made just for you. So together, we can find your way forward. Learn more at sanfordhealth.org.
Walk these fields for 8 decades. Grow deeper roots here. Know it thrives here. Bring in world-class genetics and innovative traits like Chrome Triple Stack Corn Hybrids and Enlist E3 soybeans. Refine it through pure local know-how and expertise. Do all of that, and the only thing left is the right seed. Pogemeyer Hybrids. Learn more at therightseed.com.
In South Dakota, farming is more than cornfields and combines. It's the small moments and big challenges we all face every day. It's getting up in the morning, taking care of what needs to be done, doing the best you can, and being thankful for the opportunity to do it again tomorrow. This is real. This is life. This is farming. To learn more about farming, visit thisisfarming.org. Brought to you by South Dakota Corn.
Jax, we are proud of you. Prostrallo Auto Mall in Madison is proud to be a strong supporter of SDSU Athletics. We know hard work and determination make for a winning team. So when you buy from Prostrallo's, you will experience our winning team. We will do our very best to find the perfect car or truck and even deliver it to your front door. Find the savings and selection you deserve at Prostrallo Auto Mall in Madison. South Dakota strong for 63 years. Go Jax!
30 seconds.
Looking to gain traction on the competition before the next harvest? Spring right into savings with in-user instant rebates, where you can get up to $150 back on each Michelin Ag tire you buy at WW Tire. The best part is, there's no quantity limits, so the more you buy, the more you save. Hurry and get in on the savings, because this offer is valid now through May 15th. WW Tire, delivering fast and friendly service across 8 locations in South Dakota.
John Stiegelmeier Radio Show, beautiful Monday here in Brookings, 70-plus degrees, pushing 80 even here on the eastern side of the state. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill is the sponsor of the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show. Every week, a tremendous special you just have to check out. This week, the chorizo burger. It's a combination of ground beef and chorizo mixed together, grilled. Then it's topped with chimichurri, pepper jack cheese, tomato, and avocados, all served on a jalapeno bagel. You can go there in person. The rooftop is open, so you can stop up there. You can eat downstairs inside, or you can get it to go. They'll bring it out to either curbside. They'll bring it in the back alley. You name it. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill.com is the site. 696-7978, the number. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, Main Avenue in downtown Brookings, alongside the head football coach at South Dakota State, John Stiegelmeier. I am Tyler Merriam. Baylor and Gonzaga playing for the Men's Basketball National Championship tonight. Coach, I know you're a very interested spectator in this one tonight, so who you picking?
I had to look it up who was playing. You know, we don't have TV right now, and so it's somewhat refreshing, but literally, I looked it up. I kind of like Gonzaga's story. You know, a small school, a lot of success, built a program, committed to it. I don't know much about their school. I know that they're a non-football school. But I kind of like that story. I don't know much about Baylor. It's Baylor, right?
It is Baylor, yes.
Yeah. So, I'm sure there'll be millions of people watching. Who are you picking?
I believe Gonzaga will maintain its perfect season. After the way they won on Saturday, that unbelievable finish, Jalen Suggs hitting that three from just in front of half court after UCLA had tied it in the final seconds of overtime. Gonzaga just seems to be destined. But these were the two teams everybody kind of hoped would play for it. They were supposed to play in December, and the game got nixed because of COVID, and so they're going to play after all. And so I'm excited to see it tonight.
Well, our team will be excited to see it because at the end of practice, Coach Rogers, we always have announcements and stuff, and he's going to make guys decide and go on either side of a line, and then whoever wins gets out of conditioning this week, and the other guy's conditioned, and they watch him. So that'll be a fun challenge.
The Jackrabbit football team is sitting high atop the FCS, but third straight week without a game. The University of South Dakota, because of COVID-19 protocols, unable to perform this Saturday. So the Jacks' home game against the Coyotes wiped off the slate. Only two of the scheduled four games occurred at Dana J. Dykhouse Stadium during this abbreviated spring regular season. The Jacks are still scheduled to round out the regular season in that postponed game from North Dakota State. The Jacks will take on the Bison up in Fargo a week from Saturday. 2:30 is the scheduled kickoff time. We intend to preview that one next week here on the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show. You are a Guns N' Roses fan. Fanatic might be a little strong, but you're a huge Guns N' Roses fan.
Again, didn't know anything about Guns N' Roses. And we're out in Montana, and we're getting ready to go to the game. And I come out of my room, and I hear this guy wailing in his room. And his door was open. So I go in there, and here's Ted Ortel. I hope Ted's listening. And he's got his headphones on, you know, the old-style headphones. And this is this would be late 80s, probably. And he's singing. I call it wailing. He's singing the Guns N' Roses. That was his pregame ritual. Mm-hmm. And so he and I have had this running deal, and he sent me two Guns N' Roses T-shirts from concerts he's gone to. So I got to support him, really. And so I don't mind Guns N' Roses. I prefer Christian music, but I don't mind Guns N' Roses.
Okay, now you're ruining here something. I mean, I was for years we've talked about your love for Guns N' Roses, and I thought it was legit. And now you're telling me this has all been a lie.
Well, no, I love Guns N' Roses, but I love Christian music more. So
okay, I've got a top five Guns N' Roses.
Well, you can't. I don't pay attention to words and songs. Welcome to the jungle.
You cannot tell me you like them, but you don't pay attention to words or songs. If it's not words and songs, what are we at a concert for? What are you listening to Guns N' Roses for?
I just got the T-shirts.
Okay, so what do you got?
Welcome to the jungle. And there's a love ballad. I can't remember what that one is. You know what that one is?
November Rain?
That's not a love
ballad. Sweet Child of Mine?
Sweet Child of Mine, I think, would be a love ballad. That's it. That's all I got.
Oh, see, I love Paradise City.
I wouldn't even know what that sounds
like. How about Knocking on Heaven's Door?
I've heard that one.
Okay.
Yeah, so.
All right. Here I thought we'd have – you disappoint me so much. I tell you what, Stig. This has been a special conversation with special people. And now it's time for special situations. What do you have for this week?
I was watching a game the other day, and I always border on being critical of what I'm watching. But literally, this team had three opportunities to kill the clock at the end. In the first two opportunities they had, they threw incomplete passes, so the clock didn't run. And they ended up winning. In fact, it was a huge upset in FCS football, really close game. But I thought, holy nutmeg, again, not being critical, but do you practice these things? Because you have to practice these things because they occur. And so towards the end of the game, if we're trying to kill the clock, I've talked about these three scenarios, that this is what I was thinking because this is how football coaches watch a game. Can we kill the clock with victory, take a knee, which is – run the clock down to 39 seconds, mm-hmm. take a step back, kill two, take it, you know, and then they restart the clock. Now, that all changes if there's timeouts on the other side because then you have to allot for that. Okay. And I remind our quarterback coach all the time, 39 seconds, he's got to snap it at one. Then you have a victory rollout where you set up kind of an unbalanced long formation, if you will, and you roll out. We did it a couple of years ago down at USD, tearing around like a crazy man, and kill more time, and that is 39 seconds, 5 to 6, take a knee, don't fumble, and so on. And then the last one is, you know, if your chart says you can get close, but you need a few more seconds, then that last play of that sequence would be what we call hang, which would be a combination of victory rollout and then throw the ball as far as you can, mm-hmm. as high as you can. It lands outside. We've estimated you can kill right around 8 or 9 seconds with that. And so we have all these charts done so that at the end of the game we can look and say we can kill the clock and whatever. We also do it in two minute drill with our defense. Mm-hmm. If they get an interception and they know we can kill the clock, they take a knee. If they know we can't kill the clock, they're going to try to get some more yards, protect the ball. And so, again, hopefully we're thorough. I don't know if we're good coaches, but hopefully we're thorough. I know our assistants are great coaches. They really are.
So is this a postulate?
This is not. Postulates are lessons.
Yeah. Okay. So what is this considered? Just a
special situation.
A philosophy. A philosophy of how you handle this scenario.
Yeah. But I think it should be uniform. I mean, that's something.
Well,
that
it should be. But let me throw something else out to you. Because at this point, the yardage doesn't matter. Every second potentially matters. Why are you snapping at one? Just take the delay of game and take the extra second each time. That's 3 more seconds.
Well, you get 2 and you back up, so you lose a second in theory. You get 40. You get 41 this way. Snap it at 30, 39, back up, take a knee, 2 more seconds.
But you're still going to back up after the snap and have those 2 seconds go off anyway.
Not if they kill the clock.
As soon as the ball snapped, the clock starts.
I think we're on different pages here. So.
Okay, we're going to figure this out when we come back on the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show. We got one more question for the coach we'll get to the bottom of, and some riveting discussion. If you're not entertained yet, I got nothing else for you, folks. Stay tuned. This is the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield, IMG College.
Becoming America's best-selling brand means you never settle. Like the Ford F-150, completely rebuilt from the ground up to be smarter and tougher than ever. Or the Ford Bronco Sport, with a legacy that can't be broken. The entire Bronco family is designed, engineered, and built for adventure. Plus, Ford's complete lineup of SUVs gives you the power, style, and space you need for life on the go. Go to buyfordnow.com or contact your local Northland Ford dealer for exclusive offers on the perfect Ford for you. Sales claim based on calendar year sales.
At Wiffles Hybrids, our family recipe for success has been handed down for 3 generations. Take 2 parts high-performing hybrids, mix with 1 part unmatched quality, then finish it off with our secret sauce, superior customer service. Some people may say it's impossible to get the best hybrids from an independent family-owned company, to which we'd say, have your cake and eat it too. Wiffles Hybrids, quite possibly the best hybrids you can buy.
Whether you're buying or selling your home, turn to the dedicated team of professionals at Century 21, Krogman & Company. Century 21 is a proud member of Jack's Home Team and is the preferred real estate partner of Jackrabbit Athletics. Check them out today at century21brookings.com. Or for more information on Jack's Home Team, visit gojacks.com/home team.
It's back, the return of the prestigious Learfield IMG College Directors' Cup, honoring college sports excellence across all competitive divisions, both men's and women's sports. Follow along with L Directors' Cup on Twitter or online to see which schools will be taking home a first-place trophy in June for their season-long success. Learfield IMG College Directors' Cup, a premier institutional award jointly launched in 1993 by USA Today and NACTA.
In South Dakota, farming is more than cornfields and combines. It's the small moments and big challenges we all face every day. It's getting up in the morning, taking care of what needs to be done, doing the best you can, and being thankful for the opportunity to do it again tomorrow. This is real. This is life. This is farming. To learn more about farming, visit thisisfarming.org. Brought to you by South Dakota Corn.
Spend more moments in the moment, not in pain, with orthopedics and sports medicine care from Sanford Health. Our team is here to help you overcome joint issues, athletic injuries, and anything else holding you back. Experience care available when you need it, treatment options that go beyond the expected, and a plan that is made just for you. So together, we can find your way forward. Learn more at sanfordhealth.org.
What does your small business want from a healthcare plan in these changing times? You want employees to have access to the largest network of doctors. You want flexible plans to fit your needs and your budget. But mostly, you want peace of mind, knowing your employees and company will be taken care of. It's why 8 out of 10 small businesses choose Wellmark Blue Cross and Blue Shield. See how we can help you take control. Find your best plan at wellmark.com/business.
Okay, Jacks fans, let's make some noise.
Go Jack!
Okay, Jacks fans, when he's at SDSU, First Dakota Chairman of the Board and CEO Larry Ness is usually getting pumped up about investing in new ideas by educating tomorrow's financial leaders through the First Dakota E-Trade Lab. But when the Jacks hit the field, the only banking activity Larry does is bank some noise.
Go Jack!
Bank some noise with us at firstdakota.com. Member FDIC.
The John Stiegelmeier Radio Show continues on this Monday night, presented by Covey Sports Bar and Grill. Alongside the head football coach of the Yellow and Blue, I'm Tyler Merriam. We had some very intense clock discussions during the break. But on top of that, we did find out some news. We found out earlier this weekend that Wofford, after its game on Saturday, had decided to opt out of the remainder of the 2021 spring season. Western Illinois just announced that, quote, out of the concern for the safety and well-being of its student-athletes, Western Illinois will opt out of the remainder of the 2021 spring football season, the athletic department announced today. There's quotes from director of athletics and also head coach of Western Illinois in that release. But so Western has now opted out. Illinois State opted out. Indiana State, of course, never went through anything here for this spring season. And with that announcement, I'm assuming that means USD's season is over, because the Coyotes are only going to have one game left after this game got nixed. That was a makeup date with Western Illinois that was scheduled for April 17th. So stuff starting to fall like dominoes here. Your thoughts when you hear that news?
Two things. Number one, they could potentially get a game if the Missouri Valley could find them a game and find an agreeable
opponent.
Them being
USD?
Yes. Okay. Yes. Had Western opted out before, the NDSU-USD game would have been the one that was moved to this upcoming date, and we'd have been out of a game then. And
that's
so,
a great point.
I'm excited how that all happened. Yeah. The playoff implications, if we have more than 50% of the teams drop out, if we get below 50%, then they're going to start adjusting the number of teams they take to the playoffs. And I don't think that's fair. I mean, it doesn't make any sense that at the end of the season, a couple teams from every conference could cause you to not be able to have a full, not even a full, but 16 teams in the playoffs.
Well, certainly some interesting things to come here with this FCS spring season in the next couple of weeks. We'll obviously be following it, and we'll be talking about it here as we go along. We've got to a few minutes here. Pierre Strong Jr. has 2,492 career rushing yards, 2,492. He is 10th in school history in career rushing. Can you name the other nine?
Josh Ronick.
6,744. He's first.
Zach Zenner.
6,548. He's second.
Anthony Watson.
Fourth, 3,712.
Kyle Manette.
Third, 4,277. That's pretty good. One through four right off the bat.
Is Koenig in there?
He is. Corey Koenig at 2,990 is number seven.
I'm at a loss. I'm okay. Sure someone were.
He played just a few years ago here. He's number eight.
I don't remember numbers either.
No, I mean eighth on the list.
Oh, eighth on the list.
Brady Mangarelli.
Oh, sure.
2,677.
Well, yeah, what an unbelievable football player.
And here's some other names that'll stick out to you. Fifth on that list, a kid who was sort of an afterthought that Wayne Hensel took in 1985, ended up leading Division II in rushing that year.
Rick Wigger.
No, Dan Sonic.
Sonic, yeah.
Sonic came after Wigger. Yep. Sonic with 3,304 is fifth. And a couple of the Jackrabbit Sports Hall of Famers also on this list. Number six, Les Tuma, 3,018. And number nine, Darwin Gonnerman, 2,598. The rushing top 10 in South Dakota State football history. But I tell you what, Ronick and Zenner and Watson and Manette, but can we go back to this? Kyle Manette had an unbelievable Jackrabbit career and had 4,277 yards. And he's not within 2,000 of the guys ahead of him.
Well,
Ronick and Zenner.
Yeah, I think a guy could also look at how many carries a person got.
And you that's know, fair.
Zach Zenner and Josh were very durable guys, and they got a lot of carries. And I mean, I never thought as physical a football we played that Zach Zenner would average 29 to 32 carries a game, you know, in the FCS. And he came back healthier every week. So unbelievable commitment to his trade.
And obviously in the case of Zenner, he had some extra games in there. Ronick didn't. I mean, when you really get down to it, Ronick had an injury plague season and what Ronick did. But both those guys, 3 2,000-yard seasons, Ronick and Zenner, just something else. But all right, we've got about a minute here as we look forward to what's to come this week. Another improvement week. How much can you improve with all these improvement weeks back to back?
I told Zimmer, Matt, I said football is an imperfect game, and we always have stuff to work on. So I'd love to win a national championship, and you asked me that question, and I would say these are the things we need to work on.
All right, so what is the plan for this week?
Tonight we practiced. We're going to practice Wednesday. Then we're going to practice Friday, Saturday morning, give them the weekend off. We'll have some fun stuff in there to do, but really it'll be a lot of work and focus and get back to North Dakota State and rekindle that game plan.
How unique is that you had a game plan for NDSU, you bury it for 2 weeks, and you go right back to it?
Very unique, and it'll be interesting how much of it is retained by our players. What I don't want to have happen is we put in a bunch more stuff because we have time now. We can master more stuff because you can't.
All right. Well, hopefully we're previewing a football game next Monday. Thanks for joining us. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill presents the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show. For the coach, I'm Tyler Merriam. See you next time on the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield, IMG College.
The John Stiegelmeier Show, presented by Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original, and your Jackrabbit headquarters. Also brought to you in part by First Premier Bank, Premier Bank Card, Believe in Possibility, Member FDIC, Sanford Health. Even in uncertain times, we're ready to see you. Learn more at sanfordhealth.org. Bud Light. Whenever there's a game to watch, there's a Bud Light there. Your local Northland Ford dealers. Visit buyfordnow.com. First Bank and Trust, because everyone should play hard and bank easy. And by Farm Credit Services of America. Call Farm Credit Services of America.